Hello. It's time to dive into an important subject that impacts readable videos, and that subject is accessibility. So the goal of accessibility is to design and create media that is useful to as many people as possible. And so what does that mean? Well, it means that we need to account for a number of different use cases, including things like colorblindness. So let's take a look at this. So in the US, about 4.5% of the entire population has some kind of color insensitivity, which means that they don't perceive color in a way that most of the population does. And this really means color blindness and other impairments. And we need to account for this use case because we want to make media that everybody can use. And so that means we have to think about things like color choice, what colors we're using, what contrast we're using in terms of like how words and backgrounds work together. And we need to study some of the web content accessibility guidelines and be able to apply those to our videos. And as we'll see, that even means thinking about how we animate words on the screen. So the big rule here, one of the big things that impacts the most people in this context is the combination of the colors red and green, because that is the most common form of color blindness. And so it looks like this. You see a green background with red lettering or red background with green lettering. Now, it doesn't look good anyway, so I'm not sure that you would make this design choice outside of Christmas, and even then it looks kind of strange. So again, a big idea here of just be aware, red and green when used together can be a poor accessibility choice. We also want to think about how we use color to indicate importance. So I'm going to show you a sentence here that's an example to avoid. The sentence is, when you reach the end, stop. Now, it might seem logical to use color here, especially red for stop, and most people will see that. However, thinking from the accessibility perspective, color is not a great way to use to indicate importance because it's not as, for insensitive people, it's not as clear. So what we can use is an underline under the word stop because it is not related to color. It's something that's more visually obvious to everyone who can read it. While thinking about accessibility, we also need to think about contrast. So contrast is the difference between two colors that are displayed together, and we want to use contrast responsibly. So let's look at a few examples. This is a light gray colored text on a white background. So it sort of blends in. So this is low contrast and it's not as accessible. The same thing is true with a gray background and then a lighter gray bit of text. Again, not very easy to read and not great for accessibility. And the same thing is true when we use color and the shades are too similar. So what we want to do in this situation is to be bold, to design our videos so that the text pops off the screen and is obvious and very easy to read. So that might mean using a dark gray and a white so that the white is very obvious, or even something with color like a dark blue and a yellow that, again, very obvious, very readable, and also very accessible. So along with other things that we're talking about with accessibility, contrast is something that you'll need to keep in mind.